Hello and welcome back again to another amazing episode. This is not the diaspora transition episode, but I have something here very interesting as well. We are having a meeting here, YouTube meeting in Accra, Ghana, and they invited a lot of people coming from Kenya, Nigeria, all over the world. And I have here with me, just us, and he's a content creator coming from Kenya. I've been watching him. He's, you know, doing great. He'd speak with people, emotional stuff. They are going through, and it's quite amazing. I have a lot of questions for him. So without further ado, let me invite him on the show. So yeah. Welcome on the show.
Thank you so much. It's such a pleasure to be here. what would I tell you is the response for that?
But that's it.
Okay.
To Ghana.
Thank you so much.
Wow. So how was your first impression when you landed in Ghana?
The heat.
Oh, the heat.
You know, coming from Nairobi, which is right now very cold.
Right.
Just jetting out of the plane, mm-hmm. and it's your heat with this, mm-hmm. you know, hot air.
Yeah.
You wow. know, the humidity. Mm-hmm. But it's more of our coastal town, coastal city of Mombasa.
Okay.
So I feel like I'm in Mombasa.
Okay. You are at home.
Yeah, I'm home.
You're at home. Wow. So anyways, I want to, you know, dive into YouTube a little bit. You've been doing this for how long?
I've been on YouTube for the last 2 years.
Okay.
I've been doing content creation for the last 13 years.
Okay.
But specifically on YouTube, I've been here for about 2 years now. Because I started posting on YouTube, intentionally posting on YouTube in 2020 when I created my current YouTube channel, which mm-hmm. is Shared Moments
okay.
with Justus.
Okay.
As the name suggests, these are moments that mm-hmm. people come to share
okay.
with me. People's experiences and stories.
Wow.
Yeah.
How did that come about?
Well, this is a passion that I've had for the longest time. Like I said, I've been doing content for more than 13 years.
Mm-hmm.
And so I have been dreaming for an opportunity to really inspire the world mm-hmm. through our own experiences. Mm-hmm. Like they say, if you can learn from other people's experiences,
okay.
then it's an advantage to you okay. so that you don't have to wait to go through that experience.
Okay.
And so that is the opportunity that I wanted for the longest time to bring to the people, to help people learn something from other people and not necessarily wait for them to make the same mistakes
before they learn.
Yeah.
Wow, that is really genius. Well, I'm enjoying it, by the way. I've seen some episode where a lady was sharing how she was raped. It was really deep. And I want to ask you this, how do you make them so comfortable to be able to, you know, share? Because it's not easy for someone to really open up these days.
Yeah.
And then with internet, knowing that millions of people are going to watch, how do you do it?
Yeah, and I mean, rightfully so, as you said, some of this content that we bring, especially on the platform, these are personal stories, personal stuff, very deep, some things that you wouldn't ordinarily share with the public. Because some are embarrassing, some are things that are humiliating, stuff that people have gone through in life that have, you know, impacted them, some negatively, but others positively. So your question is how we get to a place where someone is able to open up,
mm-hmm.
be vulnerable, and mm-hmm. share those personal deep stuff.
I
believe my work is more than just, you know, sharing content or sharing videos or asking people questions and, you know, them giving me answers. I believe in creating a relationship around every subject that I bring to the table.
Okay.
And so the first thing that I do
mm-hmm.
is to have a conversation before the actual conversation.
Okay.
So that we create that relationship and I'm able to explain to my guests what this is all about and the end result of what I'm trying to do. So that we are on the same page. And once someone is able to understand where I'm coming from, then it becomes a little easier for them to really, you know, stick to the game and open up about some of these things. And I tell them that, you know, which is true, it's not just, you're not just sharing for yourself. You're sharing so that someone else can have an opportunity to know or do better.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Wow, that's a good answer. But what would you say you've learned, you know, listening to all these numerous stories of people's experiences? What have you learned, a key lesson you've learned since you started this series?
A lot of lessons. One, in our interconnectedness.
Mm.
There's a lady who came to the platform and shared her story, her journey. She has a child who is 13 years old and she's a cerebral palsy survivor. And so this kid has literally been, you know, in the hands of the mother from birth, and she can't do nothing for herself.
Wow.
And so when this woman came to the platform to share her journey and just how she manages to go along, to get along with her beautiful daughter, when, by the time she was coming, she felt as if she was alone in the world. And she didn't believe that there was anyone else who could understand her struggle, her journey. Because for the longest time, no one seems to be bothered by her struggle. But when she shared her story with the world, in her own words, later on she told me that she felt like the world connected with her.
Actually, let me say that when Justus visited my home, my house, and now I think I first of all, I began by asking them some questions. And it is like they had come for me to interview them. It is like you people had come for me to interview you. And I was like, I was not ready to share my story because of what I was already going through. And then I didn't know what you wanted to do with my story. You remember the struggle we had, because I actually didn't know what you wanted to do with my story. But then I also didn't expect. I thought I was, because it was a cerebral palsy month, October, I thought that maybe you people want to let people know this is a month of cerebral palsy, and yeah, so I thought it was an awareness thing. And so after the 2 weeks, then you told me you are hearing my story. Me, I didn't have any expectation. I thought that the story is just being aired because it is an awareness month, so that people can be aware. But surprisingly, I was in a shock. I must say, I wept. I really wept. And you remember me calling you, because the first sender, I have never deleted those messages. The first sender sent me 3,000. To me, that was like now a million. Because there were so many things that I was seeing now, I knew I would clear the medicine. The house rent was, I had reached a point where I was like, if they chase me, I'm used to being chased from houses. And I had decided, me, I can just go with my things and camp somewhere and cover ourselves with a paper. I had reached to that point. But now, immediately you heard the story, I didn't sleep counting that the house has any debt. And so again, I had a sleepless night, because it was like, it was like another dream. I thought I was in a dream. So I could look at what was happening and the responses. And I didn't have a phone. Now, I didn't have a smartphone. I only have a phone that was able to receive M-Pesa. And I started seeing M-Pesa, and I was like, what did I really say to people? What did I really throw to the public? That was another shock. Because one of the things that the Lord has put in me, and I don't know how I can call it, is like, I don't like begging. Me, even when I am in my very raw moments, I have always asked God to make me bold. Even when I'm appearing people, I know how to sleep hungry. But then, after this story was aired, it's like now God opened me to the remnants. And to be precise, I think I've met God's best. I've met God's best creation.
The world believed in her in such a way that she felt alive for the first time. You know, and that for me means everything. That sometimes we keep stuff to ourselves, thinking that if we share, we'll be bashed, we'll be embarrassed, we'll even be humiliated. And yet, sharing is the beginning of healing. I have seen healing on the platform. People coming in when they are broken, shattered, but walking out with their heads held high, knowing that they are not alone. There's someone else who believes in them and who is willing to walk with them. So for me, when I see that kind of transformation happening because of the opportunity we have provided on the platform for people to talk about their journeys, it's more satisfying, it's more fulfilling. And I don't think there's anything that can match that kind of
That's amazing. And we just jump into the video because I'm very excited.
Yeah.
But I want to give you the opportunity to introduce yourself to, you know, my viewers are diasporans. They are watching from the US, UK, and other diasporan countries, and a little bit of Ghanaian. So introduce yourself, your show, how you started to them, and they can also check you out.
Oh, so I think most of the things I've talked about speak more about myself, so partly is an introduction of itself. But my name is Justus. I'm a content creator based in Kenya. I'm Kenyan, really, by citizenship. Mm-hmm. And so I am a content creator on YouTube. And my YouTube channel is called Shared Moments with Justus. It has been running for the last 2 years or so. I started in 2020 during COVID time. But it's a passion that I've had for the longest time. And so I utilize my influence and my network on the platform to be the person who can, or the carrier for social change, social transformation. That I utilize my little resources and influence to make sure that whatever it is that I believe in as a society that needs to be done right, I give an opportunity to people to help.
That is a really good initiative, I must tell you. But I would ask you one more question. Why pandemic before you started it? You could have started it.
I could have started a long time ago, but the problem has always been time.
Okay.
Because I have also other engagements, because I'm coming from a background of, I'm a trained journalist. And so I still have an 8-to-5 job. And so these are things that I've really wanted to do, but I've never had enough time to really commit myself to doing them. And so in 2020, when everybody was under lockdown, I had the time for the first time.
Okay.
And so that is the time when I realized I could actually start to do that thing which I had been procrastinating about. And so that explains why 2020 was the year for me.
Okay.
As we complain about COVID, I also thank God for an opportunity that came through.
Wow. Wow. So YouTube.
Yes.
Okay, YouTube. It's huge.
It is.
You've done local traditional media. Broadcasting, compared to YouTube, what are the differences and the challenges in both industries?
Interests. Mm-hmm. There's something about interests, and everyone has certain interests and a reputation and image to protect.
Mm-hmm.
And so what happens in the mainstream media is that the narrative is also guarded. There are gatekeepers who would really then want to influence the kind of information that gets to the public. There are interests that need to be protected in the mainstream media, every media house.
Okay.
And so for me, going YouTube gave me an opportunity, a platform to tell the story the way I want to tell it without restrictions, in the way that I feel.
More creative freedom.
It's more creative in terms of, it has freedom.
Mm-hmm.
And so that for me was a very huge difference from the mainstream media to the digital space, which is YouTube in this case. Yeah.
But I see you're maintaining both. Why don't you just... Let's talk about the challenges, traveling. You've traveled to other East African countries.
Yes.
Let's talk about traveling from each country, being a Kenyan, then traveling to Tanzania, going to all these places. What has been the challenges, making such journeys like that?
Well, even before talking about challenges, there's the vibrancy, the life that you tap into by just getting out of your comfort zone, moving out of your local areas and getting to see how other people are doing and responding to things. So for me, moving from, at least going, visiting other countries has opened my scope, my thinking, to be able to understand and appreciate where other people are coming from, so that when you're crafting your messages for people, you first of all understand where they are or where they are coming. It's very important, so that you're not speaking at them, but you're having a conversation from a point of knowledge.
Okay.
And so that for me has been the most positive thing about moving to these countries. But of course, the challenges are usually mostly around resources.
Mm-hmm.
The constraint that comes from lack of enough resources. Given we would wish to really move as much as we want and tell the African story from every corner of Africa. but now resources are limited. Okay. And so hopefully we are able to be, you know, everywhere we want to be in future, given the resources definitely that are needed.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Well, where do you see yourself on YouTube in the next 5 years, you'd say?
I don't want this conversation to be about me.
Mm.
And so for me, I would be more comfortable, I would be more proud of the legacy if so many other creators can be able to play their role and do their bit. Not just content creators, but even the audience, the people that we speak to every other time. I want them to stop looking at themselves as an audience and realize that they are active participants and change makers. So all this information that we've been sharing over time is not just for entertainment or to console someone and just, you know, remain seated. It's information that should reawaken, you know, something in us, rekindle that flame that we lost so that we can take ownership of the conversation, every one of us. And so for me, 5 years from now, I'll be more than happy to see that these conversations that we've had for these 5 years, you know, period of time, have not just ended as conversations, but they have impacted our society. They have transformed something, and we have results, we have changed people, we have attitudes that have been adjusted as a result, and people who are more passionate about our culture and our way of life, and we are more than ready to listen and assist.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. That's very nice. I'm enjoying this conversation so far. And if you are enjoying it, please like the video and subscribe. Now, let me ask you this question before we start to wrap up, okay? Do you think YouTube is a job?
It is more than a job. It is life.
Really?
Because for me, YouTube has been a very great opportunity. There are so many things I've learned along the way, which I don't think I would have without you know, getting myself into this space. But that question can be answered by different people differently. But for me, I think it's more than a job, because a job would mean that I'm limiting it to monetary gain, but there's more to it. I have had an opportunity to know people at a personal level, people that I would never have met. Right. I have had a chance to contribute to their lives being transformed. And so for me, it is a job. It is not a job. I don't know. It's of course.
Because most Africans are watching.
Yeah.
And they are inspired by people like yourself. And they see how you create content and they want to do, you know, do the same thing. But people think it's not sustainable. You know, some people quit their job to start YouTube because they love it. And they realize quickly that maybe it doesn't go that fast and they probably have to go back to 9 to 5.
Yeah.
That's why I asked that. But if they are watching and they want to be, you know, having some impact, some kind of impact, they want to follow your footsteps, what would be an advice to them? Should they go for it? What would be some things you wish you knew when you were starting? Give to the viewers as a gift. And if they're interested, what should they know before starting a YouTube?
Yeah. So basically, I think we're talking about content creation because YouTube is just one of the platforms that one can use in the digital space to really share content. But so anyone who would want to get themselves into that space, of course, the drive should really be not the platform and what the platform can do, but the platform is just an avenue, a means through which you want to share something that originally you own, you possess.
Okay.
So first of all, you must have something that you want to share with the world or you're passionate about. And so YouTube just becomes a means to executing that. But now, since you're talking about YouTube particularly, YouTube is sustainable as a platform because at least there's an opportunity to also generate revenue. You can earn some money. You're also creating a brand around yourself and your content, meaning you can also, it's an opportunity to attract even partnership and other people who you can collaborate and do more great stuff together. And so if you want to get into this space because you are passionate about a certain thing, I mean, you should have started yesterday already.
Yeah.
There's no right time, because one of the things that kept me on the sidelines for the longest time is procrastination. I wanted to start perfectly. And I just came to realize too late that there's no perfect moment. Because some of us are very particular, coming from a, you know, journalistic background, some training in, you know, production. So I wanted to have everything in place before I can be able to, you know, to start.
Yes.
And that was not coming.
Okay.
And so I got to a point I had to say, let me start with what I have and then improve along the way. To my surprise, when I started with nothing, a lot of things came into play and into place. And so just start.
Okay, yeah. Just start. Wow. Let me ask you this, okay? Africa, a lot of young teenagers like yourself, myself, I've watched a lot of, you know, Western press, media, and what we see on TV, and we are not really interested in living on the continent and even doing any impactful things. We are obsessed with living, going to US, UK, you know, to stay, because that's the dream that we've been sold to, right? What was different? Because I've traveled before, I was a victim. I had to leave the country because I was like, let me leave Ghana, go to other places, right? But you stayed in Kenya. You did, you traveled around, but majority of your time was in Kenya, right? Yeah. What was the, you know, thing that really made you kind of be like, let me just stay here in Kenya, let me do something impactful, let me just, you know, go do 9 to 5 in the US or go work in McDonald's? What changed that for you that made you stay?
Yeah, I mean, for sure, much of what we stand for as a society, as a people, is because of the influence which we receive from the media. And when you talk about the media, basically for the longest time, the Western media has defined, you know, what media is all about. So what we see, our interactions, the world has become a global village, as they say, because now I don't need to travel out of Kenya to know what's happening in America. So America has been brought to my hands through a phone and internet. And so that influence over time has affected our perspective of life. And sadly so, especially as Africans, we have started losing our values, and a lot of degeneration happening simply because Africa has not been represented well in that space of media. That space has been run and managed by people who also have interests to protect. And unfortunately, we never stood up to have our interests represented in the media. And so somehow the generations that have come up have missed out on, you know, getting to hear from the African, you know, getting to hear the African story, the right way. And but I think for me personally, I think it's not too late for anything. We still have people who fortunately have the passion, the zeal to see to it that we make a difference as Africans.
Okay.
We are not against anything that, you know, America or Europe is doing. In fact, most of them have contributed immensely into the progress that we see today. But the conversation really is that we should give an opportunity for everyone to say and feel represented.
I see. Yeah. Do you think it's possible to make it here in Africa?
I mean, we are making it. If this is not making it, then what is it? Because making it really is not just monetary, much as we are still making money anyway, but making it for me is making a difference, not just in your life, but in the next person's life.
I see.
Yeah.
I see. That's amazing. Thank you so much. I'm almost at the end of my video. If you're enjoying this, please, his name will be on the screen. Go check out what he's doing. He's doing amazing. He's from Kenya. And if you have a message for African youth, diasporans watching the show right now, what would that message be?
First of all, you had mentioned, I forgot to bring it out, that we are that young. Yeah, I'm a young person, but I'm 36. So not that young. And so sometimes I'm under pressure because I feel like I haven't done so much and the time is running out. But hopefully God gives me grace to really accomplish a lot of the things that I wish I can be able to accomplish here on earth. My message to young people, Africans, is that our time is limited. And before it runs out, let's utilize that opportunity to make a difference. Let's stand for something. Let you be known for something, so that when your time lapses, then there's so much that can be built on upon your legacy.
Okay, yeah. Legacy. Wow, thank you so much for talking to me.
It's a pleasure. I'm enjoying it already.
So this is the end of the episode. If you did enjoy, we have a lot to talk about, but sure, time may not permit us. But please go on his YouTube channel, go check him out, see his content that he's creating, very impactful, and I think you will enjoy it. And if it's your first time here, please don't forget to like the video, if you like it, actually, and then share to friends and family, and yes, stay tuned for more amazing content coming your way. It's been a wonderful one, and yes, have a wonderful day. Peace out. Bye-bye.
Great.